This video will walk you through the work environment that you need to get set up on your machine in order to work with the assignments that will be given as part of this course on HLS by example. First, we look at what are the required software that we will assume you will be using for this course. There are a number of variants on this that you could use, but this will be the software that I will be using for all the assignments and therefore will be easiest to support in terms of any questions. The assumption is that you are going to be working on Linux, in particular an Ubuntu 16.04 long-term support installation. We will be using the Xilinx Vivado tools, the 2018 version. There are two parts to this. One is the Vivado System Design Suite, which is basically used for creating complete systems, compiling Verilog code, and finally generating the bitstream files. And another part of it is the Vivado HLS, the high-level synthesis, which is used for C and C++ to hardware synthesis. Both of them come combined as a single bundle. For the assignments, in some cases, you may be able to use tools such as iVerilog and GTK Wave. The reason I mention these is because they are much lighter and faster tools for small assignments. Although for large assignments, you may find that the Xilinx tools are actually better and easier to use. For small, simple test cases that you want to write with Verilog, the overhead involved in starting up the Xilinx tools can be quite significant. For high-level modeling, in general, we'll be using Python and numeric Python, not MATLAB, the reason being that it's not always possible to assume that all students have access to a particular version or edition of MATLAB, whereas Python, the tools are freely available, and the assumption is that you can install them as required. Now, the environment that we will be using and assuming here will be Linux, in particular the Ubuntu 16.04 version. The installation options, you could either install this as your primary operating system, the only operating system on your computer. Another alternative is that you make your computer a dual boot system, which will be equally good in terms of performance, but will of course require you to reboot every now and then if you want to switch between Windows and Linux. Third option is to run Linux inside a virtual machine using software such as VirtualBox. This is doable, but problematic for a couple of reasons. One is that the memory required for the Vivado tools is generally pretty large. You will need at least 2 GB of RAM dedicated to the virtual machine with Vivado, and for larger designs, even more. And the other thing is that you will probably need a large amount of disk space because the Vivado tools themselves take up around 25 GB even for the minimal Webpack version. Some other packages may need to be installed on Linux. These will be informed later as and when we get to them. Now, of course, you are free to install Vivado under Windows and use it. That is perfectly fine and works reasonably well. The only thing is we cannot support that in general. So if you run into any problems on installation or running certain tools, we will not be able to help you. The maximum installation that we have in labs around IITM is on Ubuntu 16.04. So that's the preferred version. Coming to Vivado itself, there are a number of issues with regard to actually installing and using this. And I will be sort of walking you through some of the steps that you need in order to get this done. The first thing you'll need to do is go to xilinx.com and register. Create an account for yourself. From there, you will be installing the Webpack version of the software. There are two options. If you are inside IIT Madras, you can download a local copy, which is hosted at the URL shown here. You'll notice that it is an IP address that can be accessed only inside IIT Madras. So within the campus, you should be able to get to this website and download a file from there, which I will be showing you how to install later. The other alternative is that you download directly from the Xilinx website. In order to do this, you will have to create an account as mentioned earlier. While installing, if you choose the second option, that is downloading from Xilinx, during the installation process, it will also ask you for your license information and allow you to enter your account information and generate a license from there. After you get the license, which will be sent to your email address, you will then be asked to actually install it. I will walk you through that process in a moment. Please note, choose the Webpack version, not the evaluation version. The web pack is essentially for unlimited use, in the sense that there is no time duration for expiry of the license. On the other hand, the problem is that certain FPGAs such as the Vertex 7 cannot be used with the Webpack license, but that is not going to be a problem for this course. Keep in mind that you will need around 25 gigabytes of free space for the installation. Now, the installation itself. When you go to the Xilinx.com website and click on downloads, you will come to this website, which pretty much if you search Google for Xilinx download, this is the URL it will take you to. On the left side, you can see that there is a version number 2018.1 is currently selected. And there are three versions of the design suite that can be downloaded. There is a Windows Webpack edition, a Linux Webpack edition, and a single file download, which is around 17 gigabytes in size. The last one is actually the best if you intend to use the tool on both Windows and Linux and not just the Webpack version, but obviously it's a very large download. Even if you download the Linux or Windows web installers, keep in mind that once you start the installation, they will actually end up downloading several gigabytes of data, which is why for those inside IITM, it's preferable to use the link that I had mentioned earlier. Creating the account is on the same website, registration.createaccount.html. You'll be asked for some information such as your name, your email address. It is preferable to give .iitm.ac.in or smail.iitm.ac.in account. The reason being that if you use Gmail, I believe that the access to the forums may be somewhat limited. But at the end of the day, this is an evaluation account, so it's probably not very important. You don't need to worry about that. We can get support through another account in any case. All right, so once you have downloaded the software, if you do it through the website, of course, it will give you instructions on how to install it. On the other hand, if you have downloaded it from the IITM link that I gave earlier, what you should do is go to the /opt directory as shown here. What I'm showing you here is a terminal where I have already gone through these steps. The first step is cd/opt. So that directory should be there already. If not, then create that directory. Run the command unzip vivado-2018.zip. Of course, give the correct path to that file. In my case, I had it under a subdirectory called d, which is why I have given unzip d/vivado-2018.zip. After you have done this, which will take quite a bit of time, given that it's a 10 gigabyte file, you then cd into the Xilinx directory. So your current directory should be /opt/Xilinx. And when you look at the files there, you should see four subfolders, docnav, SDK, Vivado, and XIC. All right. Now, once you have got to this point, it means that your software has been at least unpacked in the correct place. The next step is what do you need to do in order to actually run it? Okay. And for that, I have another terminal out here. The first step that needs to be run is to type in this command source/opt/xilinx/vivado/2018/settings64.sh. What does this do? It basically sources a number of environment variables and sets up your path. Now, it's up to you whether you choose to put this into your startup script so that it gets done automatically when you log in. I would not recommend it for the reason that some of these paths tend to interfere with some other software that you might have installed. But it's your call, and please feel free to discuss on the forums whether you have success or difficulties using this approach. Once you have done this, you should be able to start Vivado by just typing in the command Vivado. And it will take a little time to come up because, like I said, it's a fairly heavy piece of software. Requires a decent bit of RAM and is also fairly large. The executable size itself is pretty large. So once it starts up, you tap the splash screen and you should see the main window coming up, which will allow you to create new projects, open existing projects, open example projects, and you know a few other things, including some documentation, tutorials, and so on. I would strongly recommend that you spend some time playing around with the tutorials and documentation, and maybe open some example projects, even if you're not really familiar with them to start with, because this will be a tool that you will need to use quite heavily. So understanding what it's capable of could be quite useful to you. So right now, the one thing that you need to do is install the license. Go to click on Help and Manage License. This should bring up the License Manager tool, which will basically show you, it will try to load the existing license data and will basically show you what is available for you. Right? In my case, I have already installed the Webpack license, but what you will do in general is go here and click on the Load License tab on the left hand side. Click on the file on the button Copy License, and over here you will need to have already got the Webpack license, which you would have done as part of the login or licensing process, right? And what you can do in this case, or alternately, you can just go back here and click on Obtain License, and it would pretty much say, get free ISE Webpack license. Do not use the evaluation licenses. Like I said, they are time limited. Once you do that, they will, after 30 days, you will run out of the thing and you'll have to go back and reinstall the license. It's not worth it. If you choose this and click Connect now, it will take you to the page where you fill in the information. It will then send the license to your email ID. Save that license to your downloads directory, then click on Load License, Copy License, select that file over here, and click Open. And it should give you a message saying license installation was successful. Once you have done that, it pretty much means that you are set to go as far as using the Webpack edition of Xilinx is concerned. And we'll stop here for now as far as this video is concerned. So you can exit the License Manager and now either exit Vivado or continue to play around with it and explore the documentation and tutorials. One last word with regard to the work environment required for this course is with regard to editing files. In a number of cases, in our experience, we have found that people are not really used to editing source code files. Of course, if you have used something like MATLAB, you would have used the editor over there. You know what syntax highlighting is. It shows keywords and function names, etc., in different colors and different fonts. That makes it much easier to sort of recognize different useful parts of a function, right? That is typically done using editors like Emacs and Vi, or of course even Gedit or Visual Studio Code in Linux. If you are using Xilinx Vivado, then Vivado has its own built-in editors, which also have like very good support. In fact, Vivado HLS has an Eclipse-based editor, which is actually very powerful because it also allows you to cross-reference between source files very easily. Please do not use something like Notepad or WordPad under Windows. Those are not at all suited for editing source code and will end up messing up your indentation, line endings, and all kinds of other create other problems for you. So just avoid that as far as possible. And keep in mind once again that actually properly indenting your files is essential if you ever want to show that file to someone else and ask for support or help. Because if it is not indented properly, then it is essentially unreadable. And we will not be able to spend enough time, trying to sort out those kind of files. Please make an effort right from the beginning to indent your files and keep those proper. That's it for this video. And in the next session, we'll be talking more about some of the design process that is involved in actually, how do you go about designing a digital system?